make a big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. Gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace. Waving your banner all over the place. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will rock you.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
Everybody,
we will rock you.
What the heart has once known, it will never forget. Please sit down. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. My name is Kim, funeral celebrant, and I am joining you today to guide you through this service, a service of love and thanksgiving to celebrate the life Thomas Joseph Lutter, better known to most as Tom. You have travelled here from different places and may not all know each other or have seen each other for some while, yet you are all linked by Tom's life. In whatever capacity you knew him, you have put aside your own cares and your busyness to be here to pay tribute to him, and to express the love, affection, and regard in which he was held. So on behalf of Viv and Tom's extended family, I thank you for this, because when you lose someone you love, just being together in this way matters enormously. So this is why your presence is so important. This service has several purposes. First, it is a chance for us to reflect on the mysteries of life and death, and to acknowledge what has happened to Tom. It is a time to say farewell to him in ways that allow for the natural variation of feelings amongst you. And while memories are no substitute for the living presence, it is through remembering him that he will continue to live on in your hearts and your lives. And it is also a time to express your heartfelt gratitude for his life and to think about how you can best support his family and each other at this time and in the months to come. I didn't have the fortune to meet Tom, but in a moment I will say a little about him, as has been told to me by Viv. And their friend Laurie will then say a few words. We will have some time for reflection while we listen to some music and say a prayer, followed by some words of farewell and a poem. We will then gradually leave the chapel together while the final piece of specially chosen music is playing. The curtains will remain open at the end of the service to allow you to say your goodbyes in your own way as we gradually leave the chapel. You're all warmly invited to gather at the Nightingale in Langford Village, where there will be every opportunity to talk together and share your memories and stories over refreshments. Any donations received today in Tom's memory will go to Battersea Dogs Home and can be made in the box provided outside the chapel or care of Hancock's funeral directors in Bicester, or you can donate online and you'll find details on the back of your orders of service. And so to tell you just a little about Tom. Tom was born on April 17, 1956 in Valentine, Nebraska, the eldest son of Jim and Margaret Lutter, and a brother to Patty, Bill, Priscilla, Teresa, Mary, and Richard. He grew up in Valentine, and after leaving school at age 18, he went directly into the military when he joined the US Air Force. He learned his trade as an aircraft technician and completed 21 years of service before he was then cross-trained into the medical field. Viv first met Tom in March 1978 when he moved in next door to her. At that time, he was based at Lakenheath in Suffolk, and they both lived in Beckrow Village, close to the base. Viv had two daughters from her previous marriage, Mandy and Sarah. But they were going through some tough times, and Tom and his two housemates, Melchie and Terry, were very supportive of Viv and the girls and became trusted friends. Over time, Viv and Tom grew close. They found they had much in common. And Viv said, although Tom was never a big talker, they were able to confide in each other, and she felt safe with him. She said the other big attraction, of course, was his stunning good looks. They both liked to play darts and got to county level, and once they won a tournament at Butlins. It was Tom's nature to want to be the best at everything he did, so he always gave 100%. At that time also, Viv had a German Shepherd dog she had bred, and Tom had one of the puppies, so that brought them even closer. And their relationship blossomed over the next 2 years or so. Tom had grown to love England, but then he was given his orders to go back to Utah. Viv, who had no intention of moving to the US, then had to decide whether to let him go or to marry him. And the rest, as they say, is history. They were married on October the 30th, 1981, at Newmarket Register Office. Within 6 weeks, Viv had sold her house, got their passports and permission to take the girls out of the country, and the family moved to Utah, where they spent the next 4 years. They then returned to England and spent 5 years at Upper Hayford, followed by 8 years at McClellan in Sacramento, California. And they finally came home when Tom retired from the Air Force at age 42. Initially, they stayed with Viv's daughter, Mandy, for about 6 months, till they found their home in Lawrence Way. Tom immediately found a job working at Bibby. Then 6 years later, when he was made redundant, he went to work at DHL as a transport supervisor, where he spent the last 11 years. He worked a night shift, which he never minded, as he used to joke it was a good way of steering clear of the boss. With regard to things Tom enjoyed, before his career in the military, he loved to hunt and fish in the great outdoors. He was also in the process of gaining his pilot's license, and he loved to go tenpin bowling. The hunting and the fishing fell by the wayside when he came to England, so then the bowling took over, and he developed his interest in dogs. He dearly loved all his dogs. The one in the photograph on the back of your order of service is Ryan, who was a special favourite. But equally, he adored the present pair, Midnight and Shadow, the German short-haired pointers. He was also an avid coin collector and a big fan of Luton Football Club. He loved to go and watch them play at the Oxford United ground when he would be in the Oxford end but cheering for Luton. Luckily, apparently he didn't get into any bother, I'm told. Tom was very capable and practical when he put his mind to it. But it has to be said that he would often start projects, and even with all the best intentions, he never quite got round to finishing things, like the two front door fronts in Liv's kitchen that she told me about. Viv described Tom as very quiet and said it would be fair to say that he related better to animals than to people. But although he was a man of few words, he was nevertheless very reflective and thoughtful. He was happy enough in his own company and could be very reserved and awkward in social situations. However, in recent months, he had become more at ease and less of a loner. He liked people, but he was rather shy. And that sometimes stopped him from doing the things he wanted to do. But this began to change as he grew in confidence. On August the 7th, he took part in a bowling tournament in Nuneaton, just 3 weeks before he died. Viv said he had so much fun that weekend. There is a saying that a problem shared is a problem halved. Tom had been a bit worried about his job security, but as usual, he played his cards close to his chest and tended to internalise his concerns. He enjoyed relatively good health most of his life, and any medical issues he had were controlled by medication. So when his life was cut short on August the 28th, it naturally came as a huge shock to everyone. Viv said they shared 34 happy years of marriage together. Of course, they had their ups and downs and their differences like any couple. But there was always fun and laughter. Apparently, if Tom laughed, you could probably hear him in town. And there was also a very large helping of love. Tom will be much missed by all those who knew and loved him.
Laurie, would you like to say a few words? Just a little bit over 2 years ago, my husband Chris and I decided we wanted to meet new people. So what better way is to go to the base? We just started to have dinner or whatever to watch people bowl and then go to a movie. We watched all of you bowl, that bowl with Chris. We were really intimidated. I said, there's no way. And then we saw Tom. And I said, I think he's a professional. He don't need to, he just looks at the pins and they just fall down. That's Tom. And he just, there's a lot of things about Tom, even though I probably knew him a less amount of time than you guys did. Yet, there's something very friendly about him and warming, and I can relate to him coming over to a different country from America, like you guys know, different culture. You speak English, so I'm told, and corrected a lot of the time. But Tom just took it, and he just gave me that little smirk. And my challenge was to actually make him laugh, because true, when he laughed, you could hear him all the way across the room. But he was a really nice person, from what we can tell, and he loved bowling. And it's a privilege to serve in the United States Air Force. And it's... it's just a privilege to have known him, and every time we walk in there, I'll remember him, and his spirit will be with us.
Thank you so much. There is a saying that your memories give you strength, and in your own different ways, there is something about Tom that each of you will always remember. Those memories and the different aspects of his character are what you will treasure about him. As we listen to the music, you may wish to say a quiet personal prayer, or just to picture Tom as you would best like to remember him, and hold that image while we mark his passing together now. Thank you, Liz. Those who wish, please join me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. If Tom was asked for his views on how to get the best from life, Viv said he would probably laugh and say, "Go live with the animals." They don't answer back, and they give you unconditional love. And of course, you all know that animal welfare was very high on Tom's list of priorities. In the words of the American writer Jack Kornfield, in the end, there are three things that really matter: how well we have lived, how well we have loved, and how well we have learned to let go. And in a sense, letting go is what we're going to do now as we prepare to say farewell to Tom. So as we move towards the last part of the service, please would you stand if you're able to. Tom's life ended suddenly and unexpectedly on August the 28th, and his death at age 59 would undoubtedly be regarded as untimely. So it seems to me that a very important part of the legacy he leaves is to remind us all of the fragility of life and to encourage us to reassess our own values and priorities. For some, not to take life so seriously, because you never know how brief it may be. And for others to take life more seriously, because it is so fragile. Maybe it's also a reminder to go home today and tell those we love how much we value them, instead of leaving important words unsaid, because tomorrows aren't guaranteed for any of us. If we can do this, we give continuing purpose to Tom's life, some meaning to his passing, and a living, lasting stake in our own lives now. We have been remembering Tom with much love and gratitude for his qualities and the person he was, and the special relationships he had with each of you. Tom will never be forgotten by those who loved him, so treasure your memories of him now, as in this last rite, we commit his body to be returned to the elements, to its natural end, and send his spirit back to the light with love. And I'm now going to read the poem Viv has chosen. Please sit down. Feel no guilt in laughter, he know how much you care. Feel no sorrow in a smile that he's not here to share. You cannot grieve forever, he would not want you to. He'd hope that you could carry on the way you always do. So talk about the good times and the ways you showed you cared. The days you spent together, all the happiness you shared. Let memories surround you. A word someone may say will suddenly recapture a time, an hour, a day that brings him back as clearly as though he were still here, and fills you with the feeling that he is always near. For if you keep those moments, you will never be apart, and he will live forever, locked safely within your heart. So as you can all see, Tom's coffin is draped by the flag of the United States of America. So I'm now going to invite the RAF Crampton Honour Guard to step forward and to honour Tom in the usual tradition.
Please arise for the playing of taps.
Thank you.
As we listen to the last piece of music, which is one of Tom's favourites, remember that you now have each other. Talk about Tom often and share your thoughts and feelings. Take what you learn from him with you into your daily lives. And in a moment, leave here with peace in your hearts and in unity with one another and with your spirits held high, as I feel certain Tom would wish.
I'm gonna Yeah.